balls of burning gas, holes that trap light and everything else, stars made out of diamonds. These are but a few of the many things that make our universe a scary but wondrous place. Beyond a shadow of a doubt, our universe is a wild place. And for all of history, man has been trying to make sense of it. Although we've come a long way in our understanding, with every passing day, new discoveries are made. Whether it's an alcoholic gas cloud floating in the center of our galaxy, or Einstein's theories of relativity, it's enough to make an astrophysicist go wild. I'm Mike with List 25, and don't worry, this stuff is cool enough that by the time you finish watching these 25 crazy facts about the universe, I'm pretty sure you'll be going wild too. Tonight, when the sun goes down, look up. Depending on how dark it is outside, you can probably see several thousand stars up there, all of which come from our own galaxy, the Milky Way. If you look a bit closer though, you might be able to spot one of only a few galaxies other than our own that are visible with the naked eye.
24.
If this makes you feel small, it should, because scientists estimate that there are hundreds of billions more galaxies in the universe, none of which you can see without a telescope. Moreover, each one of these galaxies has billions of stars, which brings the estimated grand total number of stars in the universe to 10 billion trillion. That's more stars than the number of grains of sand on Earth.
23.
All the stars, galaxies, and black holes in the universe only compose about 5% of its mass. As crazy as it sounds, the other 95% is unaccounted for. Scientists decided to label this mystery material dark matter. To this day, they're still not sure where or what it is.
22.
For those of you considering opening your own pubs, there's probably no better place than Sagittarius B. Although it's 26,000 light years away, this interstellar cloud of gas and dust contains over a billion, billion, billion liters of vinyl alcohol. Okay, so it's not really drinkable, but it's a very important organic compound that is critical to the existence of life.
21.
In the late 1950s, by way of something labeled Project A-119, the US decided it would be a good idea to launch a nuclear missile at the moon. Why? Evidently, they felt it would give them a leg up in the space race. Fortunately, however, the plan was never executed.
20.
Have you ever noticed that when the moon is directly on the horizon, it appears to be a lot closer and larger? Known as the Ponzo illusion, your brain inflates the size of the moon to make it appear larger than it really is. Don't believe me? Next time you're looking at an oversized moon, block everything else out with your hands and watch it shrink.
19.
Upon leaving the moon, astronauts on the Apollo missions described moon dust as smelling like gunpowder and feeling extremely soft. Scientists, however, are still not exactly sure why this is, because the two have extremely different compositions, with moon dust consisting mostly of small shards of silicon dioxide glass.
18.
In 2004, scientists discovered the largest diamond ever. In fact, it's a collapsed star. Measuring 4,000 kilometers across and having a core composed of 10 billion trillion trillion carats, it's roughly 50 light years from Earth.
17.
Strangely enough, Venus completes an entire orbit around the Sun before it manages to turn on its axis once. This means that its day is actually longer than its year.
16.
As big as the planet Saturn is, if you were to put it in a glass of water, it would float. This is because its density is 0.687 grams per cubic centimeter, while water is the famous 0.998 grams per cubic centimeter. Unfortunately though, you would need a glass that's over 120,000 kilometers in diameter to witness this.
15.
Whenever two pieces of metal in outer space touch each other, they're more or less permanently stuck together. While welding usually requires heat, in this case, the vacuum of space does the trick, hence the name cold welding. You might think then, how do space shuttles accomplish anything out there? Well, typically metals on Earth have a layer of oxidized material covering their surface that prevents this. So on shuttle missions, the risk of accidentally welding the shuttle to itself is negligible.
14.
Earth has more than one moon. Okay, not really. They're more like moon wannabes. But scientists have discovered several asteroids that are more or less following the Earth as it moves around the sun.
13.
Earth does, however, have over 8,000 objects orbiting around it. Most of these would be classified as space junk, or debris left over from spacecraft and missions in the past.
12.
Each year, scientists have determined that the moon moves about 3.8 centimeters further from the Earth. As a result, Earth's spin has slowed by about 0.002 seconds every day over the course of the last century.
11.
While most of us know that the light hitting Earth took 8 minutes to cross the 93 million miles between our skin and the surface of the sun, did you know that the energy in those rays started their life over 30,000 years ago deep within the core of the sun? They were formed by an intense fusion reaction, and spent most of those thousands of years making their way to the sun's surface.
10.
While it's not my intention to burst your bubble, I thought I should inform you that the Big Dipper is actually an asterism, not a constellation. There are only 88 official constellations in the night sky, and everything else, including the Big Dipper, falls into this other category. It is, however, composed of the 7 brightest stars in the Great Bear constellation, Ursa Major.
9.
You are standing on a planet that is spinning about its axis while rotating around a star that's revolving around the center of a galaxy barreling through space. Sounds like enough to give you motion sickness, right? Well, before you take your Dramamine, let's visit our next point.
8.
So, how do you know that the bus you're taking to work is in fact moving? What if you're sitting in the only motionless object in the known universe, and everything else, including the road beneath your tires, is moving instead? Well, the truth is that there's no way to prove what is moving and what isn't. It's all relative to your frame of reference. To you, the person across the aisle is stationary because your frame of reference is the bus. To the person watching from the sidewalk, however, you're both speeding along at 60 miles an hour through traffic because their frame of reference is the Earth.
7.
Going back to the bus example, if you were to shoot an arrow out the window at a target down the road in front of you, how fast would it be moving when it hits the bullseye? Well, essentially, it would be going the speed of the bus, about 60 miles an hour, plus however fast you shot the arrow. Now, what if you shined a beam of light at it? Since the light travels at 186,000 miles per second, we would just add the 60 miles an hour, right? Wrong. Scientists found that no matter what, light travels the same speed. Which brings us to our next point.
6.
As a result of the aforementioned fact that light cannot exceed 186,000 miles per second, it would follow that nothing can, which is exactly why this has come to be known as the universal speed limit.
5.
Without getting too complex, Einstein essentially came forward with the revolutionary idea that not only is motion relative, but time is too. In fact, they're linked together. The faster you move, the slower others will perceive that time has passed for you. While this was exactly the type of nonsense scientists were trying to avoid, Einstein took it at face value and accepted the conclusion.
4.
Everything I just talked about is very relevant to modern technology. In fact, the clocks in onboard computers and navigation equipment have to take into account the effects of relativity. For example, if you measure the time that had elapsed on a fighter pilot's wristwatch, you would find that it lagged behind your watch by several nanoseconds.
3.
Because the force of gravity increases near the surface of the Earth, so does your acceleration, meaning exactly what you're thinking. Time slows down. Once again, this is very relevant to modern-day society because, at different altitudes, clocks tick at different speeds. Also remember that since the Earth is rotating, someone standing near the equator is moving faster than someone on the North Pole. Once again, their clock is ticking slower.
2.
If you've been keeping up so far, then this won't be too much of a leap. The famous twins paradox states that if you put one twin on a spaceship that was moving near the speed of light through space and left the other on Earth, due to the effects of relativity, the twin in the spaceship would return to the planet significantly younger than his Earthbound sibling.
1.
At one point, black holes were actually supermassive stars. When one dies, it generally blows off its gaseous outer layers and the core collapses into an extremely small and dense sphere. Imagine, for example, trying to pick up a tennis ball containing the entire mass of the sun. The immediate effect of this astronomically high density would be an insanely strong gravitational field. To break free from any gravitational field, you have to be traveling faster than something known as escape velocity. On Earth, spacecraft reach a speed of about 7 miles per second. On some collapsed stars, though, they would have to reach a speed faster than 186,000 miles per second, which is more than the universal speed limit, meaning nothing, not even light, could escape.
Enjoying our lists? Be sure to click that subscribe button on the bottom right and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new ones every Monday through Friday. Share them with friends and help us consistently conciliate curiosity. And if you want even more lists, check out these videos here or just head to our website at list25.com.